Good morning and welcome to Park Road Baptist Church this morning. My name's Teresa, I'm the youth worker and welcome to this Palm Sunday service. Soon we'll be meeting physically at Park Road and how cool will that be? But until then, welcome on YouTube. I'm just going to read a few verses. Now Easter is all about Jesus dying and coming back to life. And this is one of the challenges Jesus gave us. My dear friends, if God loved us like this, we certainly ought to love each other. No one has seen God, ever. But if we love one another, God dwells deeply within us. In other words, he's in us. And people can tell that because of our love. And his love becomes complete in us. His perfect love. How cool is that? I know we all need to be loved. And I think it is amazing how Jesus poured out his life for us because he loved us so much. I'm just going to pray and then I'm going to hand over to Jacob, who's going to explain and tell us about the first song. Lord Jesus, I just thank you so much for your amazing love. Love that you poured out for us on the cross, but you didn't just die, but you came back to life, Lord, and I just thank you so much. Amen.
So I've chosen the song Happy Day by Tim Hughes because it reminds me that Jesus's death wasn't a sad thing, because he rose up again and that should be a happy thing.
Greatest day in history. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. Face to face, I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. In this joy, perfect peace, earthly pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. He's alive.
Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. Rejoice, people of Jerusalem.
Shout for joy, people of Jerusalem. Your king is coming to you. He does what is right and he saves. He is gentle and riding on a donkey. He is on the colt of a donkey.
I'm reporting from Jerusalem News Centre. Something amazing has happened. Could it be that Jesus is the king that the prophet Zechariah spoke about hundreds of years ago?
I don't know what you're talking about. Jesus just rode through the streets of Jerusalem on a young donkey. The crowd was so excited, they started throwing their jackets down. I tell you, the street cleaners are going to have a job to clear up all those jackets they left behind. It wasn't just jackets, though. People broke off lots of palm branches and started waving and cheering that man, Jesus. What an amazing sight.
That's it. That's what the prophet Zechariah said years and years ago, that the king will ride through Jerusalem on a young donkey, not an old donkey, a young donkey that has never been ridden before.
So, are you saying this ordinary man who is riding on a young donkey has an important part to play in the whole of history?
Yes, totally. Jesus must be the king. Did you hear what the people were shouting and what Jesus said? It was extraordinary. He talked about the stones crying out.
Yes, I heard what the people shouted. Hosanna! Blessed is the king who came in the name of the Lord. It was such a noisy crowd. They were so excited. The Pharisees and teachers of the law, though, were so angry. You ought to see their faces. And they were like thunder. They seemed to hate that Jesus. All that excitement, and they shout to Jesus, "Make the people shut up." Crazy. Even crazier, though, Jesus said that if the people did not shout their praises, that the stones would cry out. Have you ever heard something so ridiculous?
Don't you get it? If Jesus really is the chosen king, that will be our saviour. Don't you think the stones could actually cry out Hosanna?
That I would like to see. Huh. What do you mean about Jesus being a saviour, though?
Come on, Theo. You must know that the meaning of Jesus' names is God saves. The prophets told us in the Bible that he is going to suffer in a few days' time, die, and then come back to life again.
What? After all the excitement today? No way.
But you heard what the crowd was shouting. They were shouting Hosanna, which means save us. I believe what the prophet said, and that man Jesus who rode through Jerusalem can save us all from the bad things we do and make a real difference to everyone's lives.
Wow, really? What do you guys think?
On Palm Sunday, people waved branches and they praised God, saying, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." And they also shouted Hosanna, which means save us. But by the end of the week, things changed a huge amount. They went from praising God and saying, "Hallelujah, Jesus is amazing," to wanting him to die. So he died on the cross. He died on the cross for you, and he died on the cross for me. In John's Gospel, it says, God loved the world so much that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not die, but live with him once we die. So if we get to know Jesus, then when we die, we can go and live with him in his house forever. How cool is that? Now, this is what happened on the first Easter Sunday. Now, Mary went up to the tomb with a few of her friends. Now, Mary was a very sad lady. She had a very sad face. This is a sad face. Now, Mary, she walked up to the grave and she was a bit worried because there was a humongous stone in front of the grave. And she was thinking to herself, now, how on earth am I going to get this open? But when she got to the grave, it was absolutely empty. The stone had been rolled away. Not just that, she looked in and all there was Jesus' grave clothes. So there's one for the head and one for his body. That was slightly crazy. So she looked in again. And as she looked in, she saw an angel. And the angel said, "Jesus is alive." And do you know what Mary was like? I don't think so. She was like, whatever, no way. Jesus died on the cross on Friday there is no way that he is going to be alive on the Sunday. No way. Well, Mary's friends who came with her, they went home. But Mary decided she would hang around. Now, she was really upset. She was crying her eyes out. And do you know what happened? Jesus just happened to walk up to her. Now, Mary didn't know that it was Jesus. So she went up to him and she said, "If you have taken away my Lord, please tell me where you have put him." And he said to her, "Mary." And she said, "Wow, Jesus, you are alive. It's not whatever. It is wow, because Jesus died on the Friday and came back on the Sunday." She looked into the tomb on the Sunday and it was empty. And that means if we get to know Jesus, because he died, we can have a better relationship with him. We can get to know him better. He can take all the things that we do wrong with him. And that's what he did on the cross. And from then, Jesus came back. Wow. God loved the world so much that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not die but have eternal life. And eternal life is living with Jesus forever. Wow. How cool is that? Do you think it's whatever, or do you think Easter is wow? For me, I know Easter is wow and not whatever.
Dear God, I pray for the world and that you'll show the mercy upon us, the world and us all. And thank you for the many blessings you've given to the world and that you will continue to bless us. And I pray, thanking you that you've died on the cross for us, so that we can join you in heaven. Amen.
God, thank you for giving us this rough path out of COVID and sending your only child to die on the cross for us and save our sins. God, please may you let us get out of COVID faster, and thank you for sending Jesus.
The song I have chosen is One Thing Remains. I particularly like the line, "Your love never fails, it never gives up, it never runs out on me." It reminds me that God's love for me is never ending. God has also helped me with my work during lockdown by helping me concentrate more, which enabled me to get better marks than I was before the start of the year.
One thing.
Let's now pray to the Lord together. Dear Lord, thank you so much for Easter. Thank you that Jesus is our King, and even though he didn't live up to what the people in Jerusalem thought he would be, he did something far greater. He died for us, rose again, and saved the world. Thank you for such an amazing showing of love, Lord, which has meant that we have been forgiven for our sins. This Easter, I pray that you help us to share your story so more people can know what a wonderful God you are. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
You are my strength and my song. You are my God, and I will praise you forever. The one who carries me along. You are forever my shield and defender. Who is like you, O Lord? Who is like you? God, and Him I will praise. This is